from Manage Engine family. We would like to extend our warm welcome and sincere thanks to all our customers, partners, and users who are interested in our solution. Endpoint management and security is one of the main focus areas of the Manage Engine. From this webinar series, we are providing all our attendees a participation certificate for each session. If you attend an entire series, you will be offered a UEM certificate for participation. You can get in touch with our chat team to know more about this participation certificate procuring. Let me introduce myself. My name is Cyril Raja, and I am a product specialist with Manage Engine. I take care of the endpoint management products, including Desktop Central. I'm a seasoned technical support engineer, assisting customers in their implementation, consultation, and troubleshooting in case of any challenges. In today's webinar, we will focus on endpoint management solution, which has different product portfolios under management and security. During today's session, we will be discussing Desktop Central Suite, which has management and security capabilities. So many things have changed during the course of the last few months. We find ourselves struggling to cope up with the coronavirus pandemic. This is wreaking havoc across the globe. As an organization, we have done our bit by completely adapting remote work, but as individual, we need to contribute to stop the spread as well. Isolate yourself if you have the symptoms and follow personal hygiene. As I said earlier, our organization has completely adopted remote work culture, as like many organizations around the world. This can prove to be quite challenging for IT admins, who now have to consider various factors before rolling out any security configuration. So most of the organizations have these three type of users now. So one is a regular VPN user. So you will be having, you will be deployed all the recommended configurations for this regular users with VPN. The second one, the users provided with VPN for work from home. So you'll be giving a laptop and you will be putting some security policies and you will be distributing the laptops to the employees so that they will continue to work on their daily business activities by sitting in the home itself. So we have to take care of these users in terms of security hardening. So we will check in this training and we will know more about how we can harden those systems in the upcoming slides. Third type of users, users without VPN. So these users are not mandatory to check into my infrastructure to access my infrastructure resources. So they will be accessing the web apps to do their daily business use. So all this users traffic also can be managed over a secure gateway. So the system administrator has to manage the machines over intranet as well as internet or within VPN. Let us consider John and his IT team is responsible for managing all the corporate endpoints at the office as well as work from home machines. So John will be having two types of users. They are VPN users and another set of users, user connect via internet. So the VPN users, they will be connected over the VPN every day to do their daily business tasks. And so you will be having low bandwidth for this VPN users. We can also define how effectively we can throttle the data rate for defining a policy or a patch deployment in this module. And the next set of users, users connected via internet, and for them, there is no bandwidth restrictions. These users has to manage over the public internet. So we have a component called Secure Gateway. With the help of that, all the agent will be securely communicate to the master console, that is our desktop central server. From that, we can manage those users from a central console itself. And once again, welcome to Desktop Central training. Let's look at the training schedule. We are on the last week of the season 21, which is configuration and hidden tricks. This is one of the modules of our endpoint management and security suite. We have covered all the modules, and this is the last module in this season. In case if you have missed any one of our training schedules, you can always view them on the link that is shown at the bottom of the screen. If you are interested in the upcoming training series, please use the same link to register yourself. Let's look at the configuration module today. And I'm quickly running through the agenda. We have it on our plate today. We will have an overview of Desktop Central. We will be having a look at the architecture behind how Desktop Central works. I will be going to explain how we can install the product and how we can install the agents and the different ways of installing the agents to those end users' machine. And then we are also going to run through some use cases like how we can lock down and work from home laptop and how we can create a local user for those work from home laptops. And we also have I could take some scenarios and solution in my support trends, and I will be explaining those scenarios and solution and follow up with the question. We will wind up for the day today. Next, what is Desktop Central? Desktop Central is an endpoint management solution that ensures all your endpoints are secure and enables the user to use them effectively for business. A popular research analyst called Foster defines UEM as follows: product that provide a centralized policy engine for managing and securing employee laptops and mobile devices from a single console. In unified endpoint management, you can manage endpoints in a traditional IT management fashion that includes patch management, application management, configurations, inventory, remote control, OS deployment, and tools for troubleshooting. Similarly, endpoints can also be managed with modern management. All modern operating systems support modern management. It supports features like geo-tracking, geo-fencing, managing store application, profile distributions to enforce restrictions, operating system reset and recovery. Can you guess the popular operating system when I say modern operating system? If you guess, it's Windows 10. Yes, Windows 10 is a classic example in which we can manage both traditional and modern management. Desktop Central can manage both the world's traditional and modern from a single console. These are the features that you can leverage when you are using Desktop Central as an unified endpoint management solution. We have patch management, which takes care of operating system and third-party application patching. We have application management, asset management, configurations. In fact, if you are following our training schedules, we'll talk about this, or we have already completed about in this past four seasons itself. You can manage other functions, including mobile device management for iOS, Android, Windows, and Chromebooks. Then we have modern management. This is for Windows and Mac machines. You can perform things like geo-tracking, complete or corporate wipe. You can put them on kiosk mode. You can distribute store apps and manage profile distributions from the same console. Now, these are the features that are offered by Desktop Central as a complete suite here. With Desktop Central Unified Endpoint Management, you will be able to manage desktops, laptops, mobile phones, tablets, point of sale devices, and browsers all this from a central console. Desktop Center is recognized for best unified endpoint management tool of 2019 as reviewed by customers in Gartner Peer Insights Customers' Choice Award. We are recognized for unified endpoint management in Magic Quadrant for the second consecutive year. We are recognized for both traditional and modern management. Let us look on the architecture of Desktop Central. Desktop Central is a client-server model solution, and it's an on-premises tool. You can have Desktop Central hosted in any one of the supported operating systems. The architecture talks how we can manage the local area network and wide area network. When it's come to wide area network, you can manage different locations from one console. They can either over the internet or using a VPN or MPLS connection. For the machines that are present in remote sites, which are connected over a direct internet connection, you can use a component called as Secure Gateway Server. A Secure Gateway Server is a server that bridges the agent traffic to the central console, which they connect over the internet securely. When it comes to remote locations, we have a component called Distribution Server, which is used to throttle bandwidth for the data traffic between the central console and the remote location. We will talk about this in detail as we go into the training. We can choose to have the machines communicate either with the help of a distribution server or with a direct communication to the Desktop Central server. You will be also manage all the mobile devices using your Secure Gateway tool. With Desktop Central, you can also manage machines on multiple domains as well as multiple workgroups. You can deploy configuration targeting Active Directory or organizational units. So this architecture talks about how Desktop Central on-prem works here. Desktop Central is also available for closed network. So what is closed network? A network which does not have a connectivity to internet or limited connectivity is called as closed network. Even if you have closed network architecture, you can still use Desktop Central to manage your endpoints. Recently, we have also launched our SaaS model of Desktop Central. Desktop Central now available on cloud. It is running on Zoho Cloud here. So the advantage of having the cloud model is there's no need for a public IP to manage the machines on the internet, and there is no failover needed. If you go for a cloud model, you can register for the sign up in this below URL. If you need this URL, you can also get this from our chat panel also. And Desktop Central is also available in AWS Marketplace and Azure. In case you are looking to host Desktop Central in any one of the cloud server, you can use AWS and or Azure as of now. Next, we look on the components which need to run this product. There are essential as well as optional components. The Desktop Central server is a central component that you will install. It will provide the interface to the management console. The agent is also an essential component. You need these to be installed on the machine that you want to manage. There is another component called the notification server. This is an interesting component. We will talk more about this once we go into the product. When we look at the optional components, we have a distribution server, which serves as a repository for patches, softwares, scripts that you have deployed to machines in the remote office. We can create unique replication policies and intervals for each locations as per the bandwidth requirement. Then we have a secure gateway. This is useful in this pandemic situation. If you want to manage the machines over the public internet, we recommend to have a secure gateway installed in your infrastructure. Now, however, it is in case if you want to have high availability, you can make use of this. This is separately licensed. And you can also use a language pack to list a web console in your preferred languages. So these are the components which we can have with Desktop Central. We have both essential as well as optional components. Based upon your business needs, you can deploy the components and then make use of those functionalities. Next, we support three operating systems for now: Windows, Macintosh, and Linux. Please find the list of supported operating system in this UI. The server component need to be installed only on the Windows machines. However, you can manage all the clients, which is either running on a Windows client OS or server OS or Macintosh OS or the Linux OS. We are supporting around popular 10 Linux distributions as of now. If you want to know more details about the supported OS, you can also very well write an email to desktopcentral-support@manageengine.com. Our support team will help you with your consultation queries. Next part, let me look on the agent install method. As I told earlier, this is a client server model. We have to install an agent in all the machines to manage them. So to facilitate agent installation, we recommend three methods. One is via group policy. We will be giving you a starter script, a VB or a PowerShell script. You can run the script as a startup, and with help of the script, the agent will be installed on the end user's machines. Once the installation is done, it will automatically reported back to the Desktop Central console. Next, we will be having an automated agent installation from the console. We also have a domain discovery that will fetch all the computer objects in the console. So you can select which computer you want to install the agent, and from that, you can push it from the console itself. I will show you how it looks like when I take it to the product. Next, we will be also have an option to deploy it based on an IP ranges, with the help of scripts and also a manual deployment. So that's how you install the agents to the client machine to get onboarded to the Desktop Central central console here. Next part, so the 90 minutes refresh policy. 90 minutes refresh policy plays a vital role in managing large set of machines in a big infrastructure. So every 90 minutes, the clients or the agents installed on the end user's machine will check into the Desktop Central console, and it will update it with its latest contact time. And in case if there is any new job is there for that particular computer, it will going to fetch that details in a form of an XML file, and then the agent interpret it and then deploy this configuration for you. Even if you have 90 machines or 900 or even 9,000 machines, the 90 minutes will be that divided between them, and each machine will be given a specific time to talk with the server. The server has the intelligence to assign the time for each client to talk to the server. This is to avoid network congestion or bandwidth related issues. So the 90 minutes refresh policy is designed in such a way that the load to the server will be split evenly. So let me talk about the ports. Since it's a client means an on-premise solution, we are going to open few ports. Every port which is showing in this UI is going to be the inbound to the Desktop Central server install machine. So we have two major ports here, 8383 and 8027. So 8383 is HTTPS port, 8027 is a TCP port. So with the help of these two ports, agents will communicate to the Desktop Central server, but on a timely basis. And in case if you want to use video, voice, or a text chat, you can very well open the port 8443, that is an UDP port. to get it use that feature. If you want to use a remote control feature, you need to open the port 8443, and you can also use this product for doing the file transfer also during while taking a remote control. If you want to transfer the files, you can very well use it, the same product. You need to open the port 8031 for it. So you can either run it on HTTP as well as HTTPS itself. We recommend to run it on HTTPS. And the distribution server is going to communicate to the machines which is under to it with the help of this 8384. So the agent uses this ports to contact to the location-wise distribution server to get the patches and software. So that's all about the post usage here by Desktop Center. Let me jump into today's topic. Why configurations? So configurations helpful for a system administrator to perform day-to-day system administration tasks remotely and effectively. So remotely in the sense, in this situation, you will be not able to use a GPU here. So the machines will be on the user's home. So you will be not able to deploy any policies on a startup, or you are not able to push any on-demand changes on that particular machine. So in order to avoid, means in order to overcome this, we have configurations. It will completely overcome the dependency of GPU here. You can very well deploy all the security hardening in case if you want to do some registry tweaks, or if you want to deploy a script, or in case if you want to modify a power schema, everything can be created from the Desktop Central console itself with the help of configurations. So I have took few examples. I will show you how we can do it in the product itself. So before going to that, the feature level demonstration, as I told earlier, so I'm also going to explain you how we can install the product and what are the ways we have it to onboard the computers for the machines which is on the LAN and over the public internet. So here, so I'm taking to the product console. So as I told, it is a client server model. You need to install the product in any one of the machine. Put the exe from the Manage Engine website itself. You can download the exe from here. You can spin up a VM, depends upon the number of machines you like to manage. We will give you the hardware sizing, and you have the document which is available on the website itself. You can spin up a VM or a physical machine. You can create a physical machine, and then you can download this product and you can install it over that. That will act like a master server for me. Once the installation is done, I can get the Desktop Central console like this. It is a browser compatible tool. You can access it in anywhere within your infrastructure. You can also have an option to establish the URL to the outer world in case of an emergency, and you can also block it too. You can have the control in the console itself. In case if a system administrator want to access the console from the outside world, yes, you can very well enable the flag here in the product itself. So this console will be accessed over a public IP or a public FQDN. Okay, so this is how the product looks like. You could see the list of features, configurations, patches, software deployment, inventory, OS deployment, mobile device management, browsers, everything in a single console. So as I told, so that now we set up the master product. Next, we will be deploying the agents to the end users machines. So once the agents get installed, I can use all these functionalities from the central console. First, let me talk about how we can install the agent for the machines which is on the LAN. For example, if I have some desktops on a particular location, or if I have the machines on a particular site, I will be having an option to access the machines from the same network itself. Since the machines on the LAN, I can very well access those machines and I can install the agent remotely. So we see how we can do it from the console itself. First, I have to add my domain. So here under the admin, under the global settings, you have an option called domain. You can manage multiple domains and multiple work groups with the help of Desktop Central. So there's no limitations here. So you'll be giving the NetBIOS name of that particular domain, and the domain username should be an admin. It should have an admin privilege. So the credential which we feed here is going to access the admin knowledge share of that particular client and copy the agent binaries and initiate the installation with the help of WMI. You can also create a service account for Desktop Central with the administrator privilege. And this will helpful for us to install the agent, and it will also help us to target the deployment for a specific OU or AD groups. So that's how you can add a domain here. So once the domain gets added, you could see the domain details here. It will also list out what are all the computer objects in that particular domain. So we will perform an LDAP sync that will help us to understand what are all the computer objects over there. So once it's done, once the LDAP sync is completed, then we can install the agents from the console itself. So under the admin, you have an option called scope of management. So the name itself defines what are all the scope of management I'm having in Desktop Central as of now. So I can very well go to the scope of management. As of now, I'll be having all the three flavors, a few Windows machine, one Mac, and one Linux machine. In case I want to install a new machine, agent on a new machine, I can go to computers. I have an option to add a computer in the console. So by clicking add computers, it will list out all the OUs along with it, what are all the computer objects I'm having in that particular domain. It will also get it list out here. So once the list is completed, you can see the computer objects over here. I can select the computer objects. What are all the machines I want to install the agent? In case for a specific location, you have a separate OU, you can select the entire OU also. So all the machines on that particular OU get selected. In the next tab, you will be getting a confirmation. You can review it. Is the right machine I have chosen or not? So once you reviewed it, you can click on install agent. So if the machines on the same network with the Desktop Central install, Desktop Central server try to access the machine's admin dollar share and then copy the agent files and then initiate the installation with the help of WMI. So once the installation is done, you can see the machines in the console itself. From the color code itself, I can understand the machine status. If it is in green in color, the machines are turned on. If it is in red in color, the machines are turned down. If the machines are green in color, you can perform all the on-demand actions. Like I can take a remote control now, I can push a patch policy now. If the machines are in red in color, at the time there might be the machines are turned off or the machines are in a different network. So we also have a wake on LAN feature. You can also very well use it if the machines on the same network with the Desktop Center server installed. You can very well use the magic packets to wake up the machines. So Desktop Central is also distribute the magic packets. So if your NIC cards can receive a magic packet, and that will help us to turn on the machine remotely from the console itself. So this is for one location. Let us consider I have another location which is on a different country. So in this case, I need to concentrate on that particular machines also for, because I will be also having some desktop which is on my office, which is on a different country. So in this case, I can create a remote office. I can name the remote office. For example, let's take Australia. I have one of my remote location, which is in Australia. I have around 500 computers in Australia. I mean, there are desktops in Australia, which is still an office. Even though none of them is working, a system administrator job is to bring it compliance. So I can very well manage those machines from a different geo or a different country by using Desktop Center. So I can define a distribution server on that particular Australia location. So distribution server is nothing but a file server. Your machine should be physically on that particular location. It is going to act like a file server for you. So whatever the patches or softwares or script you want to deploy, it will replicate to that distribution server, and then it will redistribute through intranet for the machines which is under that particular Australia location. You can also create a customized policy. For example, your MPLS connection is having around 50 Mbps. You don't want to use all the 50 Mbps for patching. You can define only 8 Mbps for patching, and I can also tell Desktop Center at what time I want to replicate the patches from my master server to this distribution server. So this will eliminate the bandwidth choke or the network related performance issues in your infrastructure. So this is how you can add a distribution server over there. And then along with the distribution server, I can also install the agents. So I can select the specific OU which is belongs for that Australia region. So the distribution server will also help you to install the agent through intranet. So that's how you onboard the machines which is on different locations. Let us consider I have my employees in the home. I want to manage those users also. So in this case, we recommend to have a secure gateway. A secure gateway which helps us to only allow a valid or authenticated traffic from the client machine to the master console, and it will avoid opening the ports or directly exposing Desktop Central, which is installed on your data center. So this is how a simple architecture looks like. So if I am going to configure a secure gateway server, I'll be putting on a DMZ zone so that there is no need for opening the ports, my Desktop Central directly facing the internet. So I can very well open the ports from my LAN to the DMZ zone. So the machines which is on the outer world just know this secure gateway server. So this secure gateway, you will be giving a public IP or a public FQDN. So this public IP or a public FQDN helpful to communicate for the machines which is on the public internet. So with the help of the public IP, it will communicate to the secure gateway server. If it is a valid traffic, it will pass the traffic to the Desktop Central server. So it is specially designed to handle for the Desktop Central agents. And also it will block advertising the Desktop Central web UI to the outer world. So that is the use of secure gateway server. So you can have secure gateway server in DMZ zone. You can install this component in any one of the Windows client machines. That will help for us to manage here. So this is the architecture. Next, we talk about how I can install a secure gateway server. I will be going to run through a video here. So that will help for all of us to understand quickly how we can install the secure gateway server. So this will be the video. So here I will be downloading the secure gateway from the console. So under the admin, you have an option called security server settings. And in the server settings, you need to give the public IP or a public FQDN, which you need to give for the secure gateway machine. So replace it with a public IP or a public FQDN. So once it's done, next we are going to install the secure gateway to a different machine, that the machine which is on our DMZ zone. Just go to security settings, click on secure gateway server. So this will show you the prerequisites and what is the need of secure gateway and what are the ports which need to be opened. You can download the exe from here. So it is a 100 MB file, so you can very well download it and you can move it to a machine which is on my DMZ zone, and you can run this installer. The installer will ask you to input the Desktop Central's machine details. You can give the flat name of that machine or else a IP address of those particular Desktop Central server machine, that is a private IP. So once you give those private IP details, it will ask you to enter the port details. So as I told, it will be going to run on HTTPS communication. So you can give those port details, that is 8383. And you can give the username and password, which is used for logging to the Desktop Central console. Once you click validate, it will validate that the port is opened or not. Next step is going to copy the certificates from the Desktop Central server to the secure gateway. So as of now, Desktop Central and secure gateway is going to use the same certificate here. So it will copy the certificate and it will install the product on the DMZ zone machine. So once it's get installed, you can see the status of the secure gateway in the Desktop Central console itself. It will give you a green check mark that will help us to understand like it is completed or the authentication is succeeded or not. So you can see the green check mark, which is the machines from the outer world, which is from public internet and from the local intranet. So that's how you install the secure gateway in your infrastructure. So we already discussed on the agent installation for the machines, which is on LAN and remote office. Next, how we can install the agent for the machines, which is on working from home. There are two types of scenarios we came across in this pandemic situation. So some of the customers will be having a secure gateway server, which is already configured. So in this case, there will be no issue for the machines, which is on the local area network. If the machine, which is on a different location, so the users will be taking the laptop to their home. In this case, instead of targeting to the distribution server, you need to move it to the direct communication. For example, so here, as I told, we have two types of communication for that Australian remote office. So in this case, consider 100 machines on the Australian remote office. Those users took their laptop and they are working from home. In this case, I can modify the communication. Instead of distribution server, you can connect it directly to the desktop central. So you can also have a direct communication. So direct communication also, you have an option to throttle the bandwidth. So for example, in case, if the machines which is in Australia, they stepped into the VPN, they can use this particular data rate to get the patches and software from the desktop central server. So that's how you can configure or moving from one machine from distribution server to direct communication. It's very easy. So instead of getting the patches from the file server, that is distribution server, it will get the patches and software from the desktop central server itself. Roaming users, there will be no issues because they already know the public IP as well as public FQDN. So it will directly communicate with the help of secure gateway and then get the patches and software. Second one, if you are a new customer or if you are evaluating or if you do not have a secure gateway over there, you are going to configure secure gateway from scratch in your infrastructure. Consider you already configured secure gateway like we did it a few minutes before. Now you have to tell the machines about the secure gateway server details. Since it's a client server model, the agent will going to talk to the desktop central server to get the patches. So here the machines are in a public internet. It doesn't know the public IP of my desktop central, which I configured. So in this case, we have an option to run a script which we can feed a public IP or a public FQDN in the script, and you can run the script to those machines. Once the script is run, it will overcome or overwrite the existing communication details in the registry, and it will feed the new IP, that is public IP or public FQDN of my secure gateway server, and then it will communicate to the desktop central server. So that's how you configure it for a new setup of secure gateway. So I will show you how you can do it. We have a small video for it. So for example, so as I talked about a script, right? So you can very well download a script from here. If you want this URL, you can very well get this URL from our chat team. So in that KB article, we will be giving you the bat file that need to be run on the work from home machines. You can download the bat file. So in the bat file, you need to feed the new IP details of secure gateway. So consider my machine is in home. So as of now, I don't know other new server details. So this is just a private FQDN, the machine flat name. So in this case, I'm going to modify the script by giving it a new IP, that is the public IP of secure gateway, as well as the public FQDN, which is mapped along with it. So I'm just going to give that particular public FQDN over here. So that is demo.desktopcentral.com. Likewise, I'm also going to modify what is the last communication you need to check it hereafter. So in the next 90 minutes, it used this URL or this public FQDN to communicate to the desktop central server. So once it's done, you can execute the script on the machine. So the script will execute. You need to run it as an administrator. So once it's ran out, it will append the registry details over here. So you could see the modification in the registry. So whatever the new details which I put it out, that is demo.desktopcenter, that will come under the registry server information details. So once it's done, you could see the machine also contacted to the desktop central server. So you could see the machine which is live over here, and then it will come to the desktop central server to get the patches and software. So that's how you configure Secure Gateway. So just a quick run up, we install the product, we deploy the agents for the LAN machines, and we configure the Secure Gateway to manage the machines which is on the work from home. So if that is an existing user which is already having a Secure Gateway, there's no need for any major changes apart from changing from a direct communication instead of distribution server. If it is Secure Gateway is newly configured, you need to run the script on each and every machine. So once the script ran on each and every machine, the machine will reach to the desktop central server. Okay, so this about it. So next part, let me bring come to the topic for today. How we can use configurations effectively in my infrastructure. So you can do an endpoint lockdown. So for example, you can do a security hardening with the help of configuration. You can deploy the registry configuration. You can write a new value in the registry. You can block the USB devices. It will block any unwanted devices from an outsider to plug into my corporate laptop to get the data on it. And you also have an option to do it from the console itself. Let me talk about how we can block the thumb drives with the help of Desktop Central. So I'm going to block the USB in all computers, and I'm going to only allow managers to use the USB device, and only the managers going to use the secure devices, that means encrypted devices. So I'm taking to the console. So this is a product console. We have the configurations. So you could see around 32 predefined configurations for Windows here. So it will completely eliminate my GPU dependency over here. So you have two types of configuration, as you know, in terms of Windows, a user-based as well as a computer-based. If you deploy to the user, even though the user switches to multiple computers, the restriction apply on the startup. If you deploy it as a computer-based configuration, the restrictions will be for that particular computer alone. So that's the difference. Now I'm going to deploy the USB configuration to my employees, excluding my managers. So here, I already have the configuration created. So I'm just modifying the same. So here I have an option to define what type of devices I want to block. It is a external hard drive or a portable device or a floppy disk. I can select it. And I can also have an option to exclude it based on device instance ID or instance ID based on vendor, or else I can ask them to use it only the encrypted devices. So I can define what type of devices I can block, and then I can target it to the machines. I can target to my entire domain as well as work group. And now I'm going to exclude the target. You can very well create a group with the help of Desktop Central. If you are an organization very much depend upon group-based deployment, we have the grouping in Desktop Central under the admin custom groups. You can group the machines from multiple domains. Also, you can group the machines from multiple domains. That is also feasible. You can group it, and you can create a group, a static or a static unique or dynamic. A static and static unique, for example, you can have the same computer in multiple static group. However, if you're creating a static unique group, you cannot have the single computer in a different static unique group. So that is the difference. If you want to create a dynamic group based on the parameters, yes. If I want to create a group, for example, what are the machines which is running on Windows 10, create it as a single group. So whenever a new computer has this OS, it will automatically add it to this group, and you can use this group for the deployment. So likewise, you can create it. So I just excluded this. Once I click deploy or deploy immediately, it will create a configuration for me. Deploy and deploy immediately. So if you click deploy, the machine will wait for the 90 minutes interval and then get this instruction from the master server and get it deployed. If you click deploy immediately, Desktop Central consider this is as an on-demand action. So in this case, we use the port 8027. That is our notification server will notify to the end user's machine, and it will do like, hey, you have a new job over the server. So it will alert that particular computer. So that computer will come on demand to the master server and get the instruction in an XML file, and it will deploy it. So once you click deploy, immediately it will create a configuration. It will fetch the targets, and the configurations will be created over here. So I already have a few configurations. I will show you the example of the configurations which is running. So once the configuration is there, you can see the summary of the deployment. How many of them are deployed successfully? How many of them are failed? You can see the execution status with the error code. So in case if it is success, it shows you a success state. If it is a failure, you can see the failure reason here. And in case if you want to modify the configuration, yes, you can very well modify it. If you want to deploy this configuration to failed targets, Desktop Central has an intelligence to target it or create another configuration to the failed targets. So that's how you deploy and use the configurations with the help of Desktop Central. So next part, we will talk about how we can manage the local users. So I came across a situation like one of our employee or one of a customer want to create all his users, yeah, local user, because the machines which is on the public internet is not going to communicate to the Active Directory frequently. So the password management part is very difficult for them. So in this case, I have suggested to go for the configuration. You have an option called local user management here. Here he can add a new user and a change password for it, and you can remove the user. So the local user management can be done from the product itself in the console. You can deploy to the set of machines which is on the product. So that's how you manage the local users with the help of the product. So next part, let me go about the configurations, means how we can create a collection of configuration. So in Desktop Central, we have two types of collections, a user-based as well as a computer-based. Collections are nothing but combination of all configuration. So you can create your own collection that includes multiple configuration that can be deployed in a single shot. So for example, I have few configurations over here. For example, I have few permission configuration as a collection. I have created a collection. Just I'm going to modify it. So here in a single collection, I'm going to deploy the required certificate on the machine, and I can modify the permissions of a particular folder, and I can block the thumb drives, and I can create a new user account. So everything can be done in a single collection. So you just need to feed the what is the USB devices you want to block, and what are the permissions you want to define, a file level or folder level or a registry level. What are the certificates you want to deploy? Which store you want to deploy? You can define it. And moreover, what are all the user accounts you want to deploy on those machines? So everything can be created in a single task, and that can be targeted to the set of machines. Once you click finish, it will deploy this all four configuration in a single task. So you can create a baseline of configuration. So whenever a new machine comes up, you can use this collection and get it deployed. Or else if it is under to your particular remote office, it will automatically get this configuration for you. Next part, it's about configuring templates to secure desktop. So every configurations you are creating with Desktop Central, it will create a template for you. So that in the sense, there's no need for you to create it again and again. So you can create a template. So there are two types of templates. There are user-defined templates and predefined templates. User-defined templates are the templates which was created by a system admin. It's going to be on a daily routines. He might be found out these are the issues which is coming up on a daily basis. So I'm creating a template, and that template will be useful whenever there is a need instead of starting from the scratch. So if you create a template, I have an option to advertise to our Service Desk Plus. Service Desk Plus is our ITSM ticketing tool. So if a ticket raised for mapping a printer, I already have the configuration for mapping the printer in the product. I can use the configuration in my Service Desk Plus itself to close that or deploy the configuration and close the ticket itself. So that's the use of user-defined templates, and also predefined depends upon the user request. We'll be creating a predefined templates in case for the first example, if you want to lock out the computer within the this much time of idle time, we already have a predefined configuration for it. So the client computer will be automatically locked out based on the time interval we specified here. So you can use this configuration and you can modify the values if you want. Instead of a different timeout, you can give it over here, and then you can deploy the configurations to the end user's machine. So likewise, you can use this template to deploy it on your daily system administrator routines. And next part, let me quickly run through the solution, I mean scenarios and solutions which I came across in my support. So first thing, so here we completely rely on Desktop Central for systems management, and we cannot afford downtime. What should we do? So downtime is a major threat for any organization. In the Desktop Central server, we have a failover in case the server went down or it's not reachable. The agent will talk to the secondary server and do all this patching or configuration deployment. The primary server and the secondary server can be deployed in different locations, and that can be shared with an MS SQL database. So the next one, if an agent is not accessed, can the computer be configured to go and manage and free up the license? So this is one of the use case which we came across. So most of the time, the computers will be not reaching to the Desktop Central. That might be it is not the employees are not in the organization, or the computers might be moved to the store without removing the agent. That will be adding up the license for you. So in order to avoid it, you have a scope of management policy. In that policy, you can define, in case if a computer is not reached for n number of days, remove the computer from my Desktop Central management console alone. That will free up the license for you. If you want to get a notification for a computer which is not contacting for an n number of days, that can be also configured from the product itself. The third scenario, some of our computers go unmanaged quite often. Is there a way to fix it? So we might be, means the user will be having more chance to uninstall the agent or stop the service. So if they uninstall or stop the service, then the machine cannot be managed from the console. So in order to avoid it, we have an option under the agent settings. You can restrict the end users from uninstalling from the control panel, and you can restrict them through stopping the service. So it's a global settings. If you enable it, it will be applicable to all the Windows machines here. So that's of the scenario three. And the next scenario, it is painful to redeploy all configuration each time we hire an employee and add a computer to our network. Is there a way to automate it? Yes. So in case I'm provisioning a new laptop, so to give it to a new employee. In this case, I can tell Desktop Central to check for a particular OU. So in that OU, if any new machine comes up, do a sync and install the agent automatically. It will automatically install the agent for you and notify to you. And moreover, once the agents get installed, you have an option to tell Desktop Central to deploy the configuration if it is targeted on an OU or a group of machines. So your new machine will automatically get the agent, as well as the existing template which you already deployed on the existing machines also get it deployed automatically. The next scenario, I want Desktop Central to use the available system resources effectively for improved performance. What should I do? So here in Desktop Central, for example, if you are installing Desktop Central in one machine and that machine is dedicated for running Desktop Central, you can fine tune the memory usage. Under the admin, you have an option called DB optimization under the database settings. So you can define how much memory consumption I have to take from the allocated total RAM. So I can fine tune it. I can increase it, so that will enhance the process threads in the database, and it will optimize the queues on each and every request. So that will help you to do the fast processing of all my deployment. Next part, these business data breaches and cyber attacks are fearsome. Can Desktop Central configuration be of some helpful? Yes, so most of the time, vulnerability is exposed or your vulnerability was exposed in an internet, if you know about it, you have a manual solution. Like, for example, if I modify this registry or if I delete this DLL, I am able to avoid this vulnerability in my infrastructure. The same case which is applicable for ransomware. So if I am able to understood this DLL and delete it, I can very well overcome the attacking or exposure of my machine in the ransomware behavior. So in this case, we have a script-based deployment. So here in configuration, we have a script repository. You can also raise a request to us to write a script for you to fine-tune or to block something or remove a DLL or modify a registry. Or you can write your own script. So you can write your own script. These are the script formats we are supporting. You can write a VBE PowerShell or a Python script. You can write it and you can add it to the console. So whatever the script you have added, you can also target it to the machine from here. You have around 1,000 machines or 10,000 machines in your infrastructure. You want to deploy the script on demand. You can very well deploy the script by calling the script from the script repository. And then you, in case if an end user is not having a sufficient privilege to deploy the script, you can give your credential. So Desktop Central take this credential silently and deploy the script for you. And if you want to run the script on every startup, yes, you can do it. And also you can run it on every 90 minutes, or else you want to run the script to watch for some process for next n number of days means you can define how many days it needs to be run. After that, this job will get automatically killed. So that things also get configured with the help of Desktop Central configurations. And next part, I need to keep track on asset data even when I'm away from my desk. Is this possible? Yes, we have the mobile apps which is available on Apple Store as well as Play Store. So you can download the apps over there, or else you can scan this QR code. So you could see the UI interface of the mobile devices. You can see the patch status. What is the status of it? How many of them are missing, installed, and also the new feature we introduced in the mobile phone itself, you can take a remote control of that particular end user's computer. That can be also done. And next part, I want to restrict a technician to only access asset data. How can I do it? So Desktop Central have a role-based administrator. So here, everything you are deploying in Desktop Central is going to be a role-based. So you can define a role for a particular technician. For example, I want to give only the asset information details to that particular technician. Rest of them, I want to completely ignore from them. In this case, I can very well add the policy over here. So here I have an option to add the policy. Either it's for a full control for that particular inventory model, I can define it for him. Rest of the model, he is not going to be getting any access. The same role can be mapped to the users. Even though he's an Active Directory user or a local user, I can map that particular role here. That is asset manager. I can map the role for him and I can install the, or I can, so that when he logs, he only see the inventory information alone. Rest of the details will be hidden for him. Next part, I want to ensure my users recognize and trust the application. How can I do it? So here in Desktop Central, we do support rebranding. You can upload your own company logo. So you can upload your own company logo. So in, for example, I have Desktop Central agent installed. So this is the default icon. Instead of that, you can give your company logo over here so that the whatever the task which you are initiated by the system administrator, the end users also get to know. So this is a legitimate application that is approved from my organization. And then another advantage of rebranding is you can very well replace this logo with your company logo for what are the reports which you are extracting. So that's another advantage of rebranding. So that's about the scenario 9. So we come to the last part, questions. So the first question, does Desktop Central allow you to block USB devices for a particular IP range? Yes, you can very well block the USB device for the particular IP range. I am taking that same particular configuration we created for the managers to use alone. So here, I have an option to target it based on IP ranges. So I can very well target it based on IP ranges. So in this particular IP range of machines, going to the configuration going to get deployed. I can also exclude any particular IP address on this particular range. That is also feasible. So next one, can website certificates can be deployed to workstation onto multiple browsers? Yes, you can very well do it. We have an option to deploy the certificates here. We have a predefined configuration that is called certificate distribution. You can add the certificates from any one of your stores, and you can very well import it from here with the help of desktop central configurations. Third part, some questions and some keyboards and monitors have embedded USB ports. Will these ports also be blocked despite having the keyboard and mouse options excluded from the block? Desktop Central takes the information from the device manager. Even if they are using it as a part of a monitor or part of your keyboard, they will be termed as individual devices. We can get the device instance ID. If you're unable to find the device instance ID, you can get it from the device manager or even from inventory for specific computers as well. So we consider it as a separate device, so we will block the same. Can 90 minutes refresh policy be changed? So as I told earlier, 90 minutes refresh policy is designed to optimize the bandwidth for the large networks, and that will enhance the performance. And so as of now, we are not able to modify this. It is because this is one of the key players or key feature in the larger network. So the next question, how GDPR compliant is Desktop Center? So we have a team with exclusively working on GDPR, and we have come up with a feature where we have the admin or a respective user will give an option to mask the value. So for example, if I'm exporting a report, I have an option to mask my personal information like computer details or like user who logged in. I can mask it and I can export the report on it. And Desktop Central is also a HIPAA GDPR compliance. So you can see the list of compliance in our website. If you need the URL for it, you can very well ask it from our chat team. So the next question, if you configure a set of restriction site in the collection wizard, but doesn't select a web browser, does this restriction policy apply to the default web browser or all the browsers? So if no browser is selected in the deployment, by default, it will deploy to the default browsers in the workstations. How secure is my Desktop Central? So we have a security score here. So it depends upon the security restrictions you are applying in the machine, it will increase the security score. So you have an option called server settings here. So under the admin, So you have a security settings. So here you have a security score. So if I import a third party certificate, it will enhance my security score or increase it. If I run my, if I have a secure repository or a secure gateway server, it will increase my score over here. If you enforce a two-factor authentication, that will also increase my score. And we also have a SAML authentication. You can very well make use of it. So it depends upon the restrictions you are according to Desktop Central, your security score will be increased and the security of the Desktop Central is also enhanced. Next part, is there a way to optimize the power consumption level in my network computers? Yes, we can do it. We have an option to create your own power schema, or else you can modify the power schema with the help of Desktop Central configurations. So we have the Desktop Central display configuration here. So with the help of the display configuration, you can very well create your own power schema, and you can very well modify the existing power schema. So everything can be created and modified and get it deployed to the end user's machine without a GPU dependency here. Next part, what happens to the configuration if any of the target computers are down? So in case if you're deploying the computers to any one of the target computers and it was turned on during the deployment, you have an option to deploy this configuration in a multiple retries. You can increase the retries the 3 or 5 times. So if the computers failed on the first attempt, it will try to deploy it either by startup wise or during the next 90 minutes. So in this interval, if any of the computers turned on, it will redeploy the configuration. So there's no need for you have to create a configuration again and need to target it again to the machines. So the next part, My user has deleted the Desktop Central shortcut. Should I redeploy the configuration? It's not needed. So because in Desktop Central, you have an option called apply this configuration in every startup. So Desktop Central have an option to check if this configuration is already present, it will ignore it. If the configuration is not there, it will redeploy this configuration for you without creating any additional task for the system administrators. So 11th, the last question, if a workstation is not in domain, can we manage workstation in workgroups? Yes, as I told earlier, you can manage multiple domains and multiple workgroups with the help of Desktop Central. So there is no limitations in managing it. So you can manage all the workgroup machines as well as domain computers with the help of the product. So that's all about today's training session. You can rate us on my presentation from the scale 1 to 5, where 5 is the best. We can also have an expert panel with us in case if you want to schedule a demo, you can very well raise a request to them, or else you can register the demo request in the below URL. So you can have a separate consultation call, depends upon your infrastructure need. We can also tweak the process for you and we can get it address your pain points as soon as possible. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you so much for your patience in listening to me. You all have a great day. Stay safe. Bye-bye.